Over the last 20 years, there haven't been many DJs or producers who've made their mark on electronic music in quite the same way as Laurent Garnier. Tracks like Wake Up, Acid Eiffel, Crispy Bacon, or The Man with the Red Face are now considered timeless classics. Laurent has shown that there's more than just one string to his bow by also proving himself as a writer with the publication of his book, Electroshock. But rather than simply enjoying fame and complacency, he constantly turns his attention to new projects, and the border surrounding house and techno territory is something he's long surpassed. He's been touring the world together with Scan X and Benjamin Rippett under the name of LBS for a while now. Their gig in his former home base Rex Club in Paris seemed like nothing short of the perfect opportunity for an interview with Slicers.
The idea behind LBS was to DJ a little bit, so give what people want from me, and as well stay with the versatility, you know, and the freedom of being able to build tracks for the people and do something special. It's like a lab, you know. So we're going there, we try new tracks, play them live. If it works, we might record them. The way we interact with each other is always very different every night. And I really wanted to bring that to the clubs and make something more free than what you can do, you know, when you play on a fixed format. I think we all need to try new projects and do different things, because otherwise if you keep repeating yourself and doing the same thing, it's getting boring. And I guess, you know, this is when you're starting to dig your grave. So for me to be excited, I need new projects all the time. You know, I've been doing this for 20 years. So I guess the key of the fact of me being, you know, being there for 20 years and still do it, and still it looks like I still attract crowd, and you know, and they still like what I play. I think it's the fact that I always try to give them something new and bring new projects. Musical side has always been in my work. First of all, in my productions. You know, I guess when I started doing tracks like Man with a Red Face, I was very attracted by jazz and by, you know, improvisation and stuff like that. And this is when I met all these guys. So playing live and, you know, making it more musical than what a lot of techno acts are was always something I wanted to go in. You know, it was my thing. So music is very important in techno music, and unfortunately now we're living in a time where a lot of producers are forgetting this. They forget the basic of what music should be. It should be musical sometimes, you know. And now we're in a minimal phase where it's kind of weird to make music. You know, it's strange to make music. But the funny thing is with LBS. You know, today we were on the train coming back from Mannheim, and then two kids walked past. They were very young, and they, you know, they came to us and they said, "Thank you." And I said, "Thank you." And I said, "But you know, why are you so happy?" And the guy said, "We love the fact that your room was very musical. You know, there was notes, there was chords, and we heard some music." And they were really young to say that. And I said to them, "But you know, you should be into the more techno stuff." And they were, "Yeah, we love it. But it's so nice to go, you know, to hear a band or hear a DJ that just plays music. This is where my heart is. So you know, I'm not lying when I just play music. It's my thing." We'll be right back. course I need the challenge. I need to be excited. I think if I would DJ the same way I started 20 years ago, I think I would have disappeared. I'm sure. I'm someone who needs to be excited, who needs new projects to move on. This is why I worked with a contemporary choreographers. This is why I worked with the cinema. This is why I did a jazz band. This is why, I don't know, I did a tour with Jeff Mills and we only played funk and soul and stuff like that. This is why I do radio show. This is why I'm still there as well. It's because all these, you know, just keeps me awake. Music is a complete land of freedom. Music is like food. You don't eat chicken every day. You don't just eat one style of, you know, of food. I love Italian food. I love Chinese food. I love Thai. It's true. I love food, and wine and stuff like that. You know, I love life. But what I mean is, music is very similar to that. You know, sometimes some people say to me, "Yes, you know, why do you play all these kinds of music?" I'm like, "Well, do you eat chicken every day?" And the guy goes, "No." I said, "Well, for me, it's the same in music. You know, I don't listen to techno every day." I think there's a moment for everything, and for me, there's beautiful music everywhere in all sorts of different styles, and I can't see why I should narrow myself to play one thing. It's stupid to just play one thing. You know, I guess you don't just listen to jazz at home, or you don't just listen to techno. You listen to everything. I listen to pop, I listen to French songs, I listen to rock and roll, I listen to punk, but then in the morning I don't listen to that. I listen to classical music. It's just different. And that's my life. That's the way it is. I need spices.
Monsieur Philippe Nadeau est dans la maison!
I never liked going to school, so I can't consider myself as a teacher. Teacher is someone who's imposing something to you. We're not imposing anything, you know. Maybe a little bit when you play as a DJ in a club, but my job as a DJ, the first thing I have to do is to watch the crowd and try to read the crowd. So a teacher doesn't do that. A teacher will tell the kids to shut up, and then he will do his lesson, and that's it, and then walk out the room. He's not gonna work with the mood of the kids. My job as a DJ, the first thing to do is you look at the crowd, you try to read them, understand them, and then you go with them. And it's a relationship. So no, I can't see myself as a teacher. No, not at all. I feel that one of the biggest problems nowadays, it's the lack of content. There's a lot of package, a lot of really good package, you know, packaging. And unfortunately, we are in a time now where packaging sells better than content, which is completely different than what the idea was behind techno at the beginning. It's kind of weird because 15 years ago, the whole thing with techno was called faceless techno, you know. A lot of guys had a lot of different projects under different names. It's one guy, 10 different projects, all different names. And the whole motto was like, I don't want people to know it's me. And, you know, I'm not important. What's important is my music. And I guess I'm part of this thing, you know. I'm part of this world where the music is the main thing for me. And it's quite true. We've been touring a lot with the band before and now with LBS, and we're getting cross to a lot of guys which really, they care very much about the packaging. So they have great lights and, you know, great designs and stuff like that. But usually sometimes the content is a bit poor. And I found that a little bit weird. The problem is now, it's like a big competition. If you don't have a big show, festivals don't want you. It's weird, because now festivals, they book a lot of acts more for the show than for the music.
C'est bon ça! Dimanche soir au Rex, c'est bon!
I think we're living in a very exciting time, music-wise. There's never been so much, never, ever before. I mean, I see because I receive a lot of music, and I've never received as much as music than what I do now. What I find really interesting nowadays is dubstep is a funny example, because it started as being pretty dark, pretty hard. It was very influenced by grime and reggae, of course, but it was more like a grimy thing, and it was something quite nasty. And then within the years, within like the last 2 years, dubstep moved on more towards techno, more towards musicality. You know, dubstep is really becoming something quite light and quite dreamy, quite spacey, and really musical, which is really, really weird, you know, to see these guys, which was, it was quite tough, and it became very, very musical. And I think techno is a big thing for them. And now a lot of dubstep guys are just mixing techno beats and stuff like that. It's really interesting. So dubstep is moving on. But what I mean, I think rock and roll has moved on a lot as well. You know, a lot of people that are making songs, pop music and rock, they're incorporating as well a lot of electronic music within their music. And I think rock has really changed for the last 5 years. You know, we've just seen a lot of kind of hybrid bands which are, you know, making really strange stuff, and it's becoming really exciting. And this was not exactly like that before. Before it was, you were making rock, or you were making techno, or you were making jazz. But then now I feel like everybody's kind of meeting, and there's a lot of different influences within all styles of, you know, different kinds of music. And I found the moment really, really exciting. There's a lot of music, a lot of really exciting things. And yeah, I find it quite healthy. I've never been a nostalgic person, never. I never say it was better before. Before it was different, that's it. And I think it's really exciting. How can I be nostalgic when, you know, yesterday was a time where it was unbelievable. I still live a lot of unbelievable nights. I was in Miami last week. We did LBS in front of 10,000 people. We thought we were gonna get killed because, you know, it was just full of cyber kids, and they're into trance, and we thought then they're gonna hate us. It was unbelievable. We got the room like that, and people were just like going crazy. How can I be nostalgic when I still live a lot of amazing time? No, I'm not nostalgic. You know, it was fun before. Of course, rave days were great, but that's past, it's gone, you know? And tomorrow is really exciting. There's lots of other things to do, of course. What's on your mind?